Hey everybody, it's Dr. Will Cole. We're live here in our Functional Medicine Health Center where we see patients around the world via webcam and phone consultations and locally in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And we are doing a simulcast on Instagram Live at the same time, guys. This is the second time we've done it. We're next level here. So for people that are watching this live on Facebook, live on Instagram, and on replay on Facebook, hello. My name is Dr. Will Cole. Again, I told you a little bit about myself, but my doctorate is from Southern California, University of Health Sciences in Los Angeles, and my postdoctoral education and training is through the Institute for Functional Medicine and Functional Medicine University. Again, we see patients around the world via webcam consultations. About 75-80% of our patients are done just like we're talking now, via webcam and phone. And a few of our patients, about 25% of them, are locally in the Pittsburgh area. So I'm on mindbodygreen.com, the biggest health website, wellness website in the world. They have like over 50 million reach and growing. And I'm one of their course instructors and wellness experts where I've, over the past 10 years, got to teach about functional medicine and talk about functional medicine. I love what I do. Today we're going to talk about the American Heart Association's recent release statement about saturated fats, specifically as far as the blogosphere and social media and the USA Today article, the now infamous USA Today article saying coconut oil is not healthy, has never been healthy. So this caused obviously a big explosion because people are using coconut oil. They thought it was healthy. It's definitely a fad as far as in the health world, and people that are trying to do healthy things, they're going for coconut oil, right? And now they're reading that it's unhealthy. The American Heart Association of all groups are saying this is unhealthy. And what's the deal? What's going on here? So yesterday on MindBodyGreen, I was a part of a few different colleagues and friends of mine in the functional medicine world to give our perspective on the data, on the research, and kind of contrast that with the American Heart Association's, because I think most of us in functional medicine, not all of us, are going to say that, look, this is a sensationalized headline, to say the least, and let's look at the context of it and boil it down to the facts and not just hyperbole. So before we get into all of that stuff, for those of you that do not know what functional medicine is, really, what the heck is this guy talking about, check my past Facebook videos to dig deeper into what functional medicine is. On people on Instagram, hop over to the Facebook page to do that. All right, guys, so the American Heart Association, this sort of statement that has been made out, I think has been more popularized because of the USA Today article with the sensationalized headline of, you know, coconut oil is not healthy, it's never been healthy. And why is it? It's because that the American Heart Association, the AHA, kind of looked at a big sort of summarization of not new data, but actually a lot of old data, and said that foods that are high saturated in fat and high in saturated fats, coconut oil being one of them, dairy and meat being the other ones, but this sort of plant-based fat that a lot of people are going to because of its, you know, purported health benefits, the fact that it helps people burn fat, burn fat and lose weight and give them energy from an MCT oil standpoint, and now the American Heart Association is saying that is not healthy. So for all the cool research and the hyperlinks to PubMed and the meta-analysis and the peer-reviewed literature, you can click in the comment section below where I did write my full statement on our blog at drwillcole.com. People on Instagram, hop on over to the Facebook page or go to drwillcole.com. So anyways, let's talk about it, guys. Coconut oil, and like I said in my article, is that this is not new news, the fact that coconut oil is high in saturated fats, and it may, and in a lot of people, it's going to raise their cholesterol to some degree. This is not new news. The problem is here, and I think the misnomer that's still really going on here, is that total cholesterol is in fact a pretty poor predictor for assessing heart attack and stroke factors, because there are many studies to show. The British Medical Journal, BMJ, showed recently that diets high in saturated fats actually show the opposite, decreasing risk factors for heart attack and stroke. So first of all, about half of people who have heart attacks and strokes, depending on the studies that you look at, of people that die from heart attacks and strokes actually have low cholesterol. So it's not a good predictor for heart attack and strokes. What are better predictors for heart attack and strokes? It's not total serum cholesterol, and it's not just looking at LDL-C either. So we have to look at things like small dense LDL particles, which is a subfractionation. LDL actually has two different subtypes. You have small dense LDL particles, which are like little oxidized rusted BB bullets that can tear through arterial walls. It's not good, it's oxidized, it's inflamed, it's rusted. And then the other subtype, subtype A, LDL, is the large buoyant particles. These are like fluffy, buoyant cotton balls. They're protective, just like HDL, which everyone kind of knows. That's what they reference as good cholesterol. So what we are looking at in functional medicine is the context of LDL. Is it the inflamed pattern B particles, these sort of BB bullets, or is it pattern A? So high small dense LDL particles is a risk factor, but looking at LDL-C, it may be good, it may be bad. Context is important. Also, low HDL is a risk factor for heart attack and stroke. This good cholesterol, low levels of it in functional medicine, we want it to be above 59, in the 60, 70, and 80 range HDL levels, and making sure the particles of HDL are optimal as well. Also, we want to look for high levels of triglycerides. Anything above 100 in functional medicine is outside of the functional range. So high triglycerides or circulating fat is an increased risk factor for heart attack and stroke. And then I would say also looking at inflammation biomarkers like C-reactive protein or high sensitivity CRP. Anything above 1 is increased risk of heart attack and stroke. It's inflammation outside of the functional range, as well as homocysteine above 7 is what the functional medicine range, the optimal thriving healthy range, is above 7 units. So the reference range for the lab is going to be anywhere between 10.4 to 14, depending on the bell curve average of that specific lab that you're going to. But high homocysteine, high C-reactive protein, inflammation is really the commonality between everybody that's having heart attacks and strokes. So these are good predictors for heart attack and stroke. So to say a high cholesterol or a high saturated fat food like coconut oil raises serum cholesterol and therefore that's bad, that is a very inadequate, incomplete view of increasing risk of heart attack and stroke, because you can have high total serum cholesterol above 200, above 250, and it be good context, good quality, and you can have low cholesterol and have really bad quality, a bad context. So we have to look at in the nuance of the total landscape of your lipid panel and not just cherry picking a number if it's above 200 and say that's a problem and give them a statin drug and that's the solution then to this issue. So coconut oil, research shows, is going to raise cholesterol for some people, and if not the majority of people, but what research is showing is that it actually raises HDL, good cholesterol, it raises the large buoyant cotton ball fluffy buoyant LDL particles, pattern A, and it also decreases triglycerides. These are all good things. This is what are good biomarkers to have if you want a healthy lipid panel, and it decreases inflammation. So a lot of the research that was sort of based on switching saturated fats for polyunsaturated fats is something what the American Heart Association advocates is based on something called the Minnesota Coronary Experiment. It was done like 40 years ago in the 60s and 70s, and what recently, the British Medical Journal, the BMJ, actually did a reevaluation of that data and found that the people in the Minnesota coronary experiment had a 22% increase of death for every 30 points their cholesterol went down by swapping saturated fats to polyunsaturated fats such as corn oil. The American Journal of Clinical Nutrition also has done recent research, and again, all of this is in the article with the references in the comment section below on Facebook. People on Instagram can move over to Facebook to check out the full data on that. Pacific Islanders, some really cool research looking at the Pacific Islander culture and where the predominance of their diet and specifically their fats are like 60-some percent the form of coconut meat and coconut fat actually have really high HDL, really good fluffy buoyant LDL, low triglycerides, low inflammation levels. So we're getting confused here between actually what is risk factors and what is not. So total cholesterol is in an incomplete view of determining cardiovascular risk. So the fats that people are being told to have, these polyunsaturated fats like vegetable oil, corn oil, soybean oil, these things, these polyunsaturated fats tend to drive inflammation up. They are highly volatile, they are highly oxidized, and they drive inflammation up, which, you know, according to the British Medical Journal's reevaluation of the Minnesota coronary experiment actually showed an increased risk factor as their cholesterol dipped. Because why? Cholesterol came down, the inflammation came up. That's no bueno when it comes to a healthy heart. So I think this kind of drives home the point here that it is sensationalized headlines. It's not looking at the context of the data. There's really exciting research done to look at the context of it all. But when is coconut oil not good for you? It is when it is mixed with refined carbohydrates like refined grain, wheats, and pasta, and eating fried foods that are fried in bad fats like the polyunsaturated fats, the partially hydrogenated fats, and also sugar and pastries and desserts and candy and things like this. Those sort of mixed meal, as the research references, mixing the saturated fats with refined carbohydrates will amplify the negative impact of carbohydrates. It will amplify the inflammatory impact of the effect of refined carbohydrates. So this is a problem. So if someone's not going to eat a decent amount of vegetables, a variety of different plant foods, then I would, and if they aren't going to give up the junk food, I would limit saturated fat intake. I would limit foods like coconut oil and these other, grass-fed ghee and organic grass-fed butter. I would limit those saturated fat sources because the mixed meal, the saturated fat plus the carbohydrate, the carbs and the sugar, that mixed meal will create sort of an atomic bomb of inflammation, which is no good. But fat in and of itself, not in the presence of refined carbohydrates, which is bad by itself anyways, but good fats by itself with healthy carbs, with healthy amounts of protein, these things actually drive inflammation down and improve lipid panels, which is good for heart health. Obviously, people know coconut oil also has a decent amount of MCT oil, medium chain triglycerides, which is good for brain function, which is good for burning fat. It also has some antimicrobial aspects of it as well, and caprylic acid, which helps clean up the microbiome. So this, guys, is the functional medicine perspective, at least mine, and I would say the overwhelming majority of my colleagues, what functional medicine really excels at, finding out what your body loves, what your body hates, and depending on your diet, depending on your labs, different amounts of these foods are important, but to totally make blanket statements and demonize a whole food is inadequate and incomplete, to say the least. All right, guys, for more information about functional medicine, you could go to drworldcole.com. If you have any questions on the American Heart Association study or any of the things that we're talking about, you can comment in the comment section below on Facebook. People on Instagram, you can hop over there, and I'll be answering those questions throughout the weeks to come as this video is online. All right, guys, I will see you all later. Have a great day.